The F-35 fighter is the technically most advanced fighter jet currently in serial production. It's capable of performing a diverse array of missions, from air-to-air combat to precision bombing to radar jamming to intelligence gathering. With 16 countries having committed to purchasing it, the advanced jet is receiving widespread acceptance across various nations. While the original configuration is very well thought out, it will need significant upgrades to maintain its edge, as the fighter will be operating until 2070. In line with this, the Joint Program Office has begun executing the most ambitious round of upgrades since the fighter's inception 2 decades ago, called Block 4. Block 4 will introduce over 75 major upgrades to the fighter. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how F-35 is getting much more lethal. Let's get started. To enable the fighter for the Block 4 upgrade, it will get a Technology Refresh 3 enhancement. One could view the TR-3 initiative as a form of brain transplant that will grant the fighter an immense boost in computational capabilities and memory storage. Additionally, the new system architecture is tailored not only to enhance the functionality of nearly every system on board, but also to simplify the integration of future upgrades. As part of the TR-3 program, a new computing core has been incorporated, which boasts a remarkable 25-fold increase in processing power compared to the current F-35. As per defense contractor L3Harris, this power boost will be combined with other enhancements to deliver an even more astonishing 37-fold increase in computing power in due course. The upgraded processor is expected to have a significant impact on a wide range of onboard systems, such as radar processing, electronic warfare suite, guidance, communications, and the distributed aperture system. In support of all this new power is a similarly impressive 20-fold increase in data storage. While the Technology Refresh 3 effort could be seen as laying the foundation for massive upgrades to come, the truth is this effort alone will result in a dramatic uptick in the fighter's capability set. A significant part of the Block 4 upgrade will come in the form of newly integrated weapons, which, according to some reports, include the Joint Strike Missile, the AGM-88G, Advanced Anti-Radiation Guided Missile Extended Range, AARGMER, for taking down enemy air defenses at standoff ranges, and European Meteor air-to-air missile, which is widely considered to be the best beyond visual range air-to-air weapon. Importantly, the weapon's payload will also increase. Block 4 reportedly includes an expansion of the F-35's internal weapons carriage capacity. Today's F-35s fly with a maximum of just 4 weapons stored internally while maintaining a stealth profile. But Block 4 will increase that to 6, allowing the fighter to carry more ordnance into the fight than ever before. Lockheed Martin has designed a new weapons rack named Sidekick to enable the F-35A and C to carry 2 more missiles internally. Sidekick adds a little extra weight, but enables each of the 2 weapons bays to carry 3 AIM-120s instead of the current 2, for a total of 6 internally carried AMRAAMs. This puts it at par with F-22 Raptor in this aspect, and greatly enhances its overall lethality in the air-to-air combat arena. Currently, F-35s fly with the Northrop Grumman-sourced AN-APG-81 active electronically scanned array radar on board, widely touted as the most powerful and capable radar system ever to fly in a tactical fighter. The system is highly potent, enabling it not only to detect and trail targets in the air and on the surface, but also to function as an electronic warfare tool, disrupting adversary radar systems while airborne. Nonetheless, despite its excellent capabilities, it's set to be superseded by an even more robust radar array called AN-APG-85. Northrop Grumman has said only that this new radar system will incorporate some of the latest technologies available and help ensure air superiority. This has led many to speculate that this new radar will use GAN, or gallium nitride-based TRMs, transmit-receive modules. The newly introduced TRMs provide a substantial boost in power transmission and clarity, even in the face of electronic countermeasures. Additionally, they offer superior thermal management, enabling more power to be channeled through them for both target acquisition and electronic warfare operations. As Aviation Week's Steve Trimble reported, this new design has the potential to double the F-35's target detection range with the same power output and the same size array, giving the F-35 a distinctive edge against other fighters in beyond visual range engagements. The AN-AAQ-37 Electro-Optical Distributed Aperture System, DAS, in F-35 enables unprecedented situational awareness. DAS consists of 6 high-resolution infrared sensors mounted around the F-35's aim frame in such a way as to provide unobstructed spherical 4π steradian coverage and functions around the aircraft without any pilot input or aiming required. The DAS provides 3 basic categories of functions in every direction simultaneously. 1. Missile detection and tracking, including launch point detection and countermeasure cueing. It can detect and track ballistic missiles to ranges exceeding 800 miles or 1,300 kilometers, and has also demonstrated the ability to detect and track multiple small suborbital rockets simultaneously in flight. 2. Aircraft detection and tracking, situational awareness, IRST, and air-to-air weapons cueing. 3. Imagery for cockpit displays and pilot night vision. Pentagon says that the upgrade to the DAS will increase performance and reliability with a larger pixel focal plane array and higher operating temperatures. F-35's increasingly complicated onboard computers need more electric and cooling capabilities. In order to power all these new systems, the F-35 will need an engine upgrade, which led to a battle between engine providers, General Electric and the F-35's current engine producer, Pratt & Whitney. Pratt & Whitney proposed what the company calls an evolutionary engine core upgrade, ECU, that would increase the jet's existing F-135 engine's thrust by 10%, while improving fuel efficiency by 5%, resulting in what they claim is a 7% increase in range. GE, on the other hand, proposed integrating their XA-100 adaptive cycle engines that offer a 25% increase in fuel efficiency, a 20% increase in thrust, twice the heat management, and as much as 35% more range. U.S. Air Force Secretary Frank Kendall informed the media that the service finally made its call by closing its adaptive engine transition program. While this marks a setback for General Electric and curtails any chances for a revolutionary upgrade, the engine core upgrade, ECU, by Pratt & Whitney is still a significant boost, especially since it comes in at half the development cost.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.